Okay, welcome ulit dito sa bago na naman nating topic, built up and reinforced beam. Okay, so this is already module 6. So built up beams is timber made up of several pieces fastened together forming one of larger dimensions. The composite unit is joined together by screws, nails, bolts, or glue. Okay, so ganito yan. Sa ibang bansa, uso yung mga ganitong built-up beams. May mga company, may mga manufacturer ng ganitong mga beams. Okay? So, and these are better in terms of load bearing capacity. Okay? Mas mahaba yung span ng kanilang kakayanin na. So, may mga manufacturer sila. Pero dito sa Pilipinas, walang masyado. Ano kang pinagpapawal na nga rin ang kahoy. Pag-harvest ng kahoy. Okay? So, but anyway, we will also learn how to design or how to analyze this type of beams. So, the moment of inertia of the built-up section is just the total of the inertia of all the so, tingnan natin, we can divide them into rectangles, yan, ganyan. And then, kunin natin yung total moment of inertia at the neutral axis. Okay? So, this one, I sub I is equal to the moment of inertia of the individual segment about its own centroidal axis. Okay. And this one is the area of the individual segment. And the distance from centroid of the segment to the neutral axis. So, bawat, for example, itong first segment, ang distance niya ng kanyang centroid dito sa neutral axis. Okay. So, ganun lang naman yan. So, flexural strength of the built-up section is MC over I. So, this is a composite section. Okay? So, hindi na siya superimposed. Kaya, we will take the flexural stress as gamit itong formula na to. Magagamit natin to. Okay? So, shearing strength of a built-up section is also VQ over IV, where Q is the static moment of area. Okay? So, the spacing of connectors para mapag-connect-connect natin yung mga built-up section is screw, nails, bolts, glue, or any other similar mechanical connectors. Okay, so R is the shear capacity. So, ito yung spacing ng screw or nails or bolts, etc. is equal to RI over VQ. So, shear capacity of bolts is R and the maximum shear. Moment of inertia of section with respect to neutral axis is this I. And the static moment of inertia is Q. Now, for reinforced beams, okay, so, kadalasan, a solid timber beam will be reinforced, okay, where it is needed, okay. For example, kailangan niya na ma-increase natin yung kanyang flexural capacity at simple span siya. Siyempre, lalagyan natin ng steel doon sa may mid-span, malapit sa may mid-span, okay. Kasi doon yung maximum moment, okay, lalagyan natin. On, of course, i-coconnect din natin yan. Iatas natin yung mga reinforcement na to. Ayan, using bolts, nails, screws, and anything else. Okay? So, flexural formula. Do not apply directly to composite beams because it was based on assumption that the beam was homogeneous. Okay? It is therefore necessary to transform the composite material into equivalent homogeneous section. Okay? So, ang ibig sabihin nun, hindi naman kahoy ito. Okay? Okay, minsan ginagamit aluminum or mga metals, okay, like steel. Okay, so magkaiba sila ng strength sa kahoy. Okay, so hindi sila homogeneous in. Okay, so ang ginagawa dito is kino-convert yung steel section into an equivalent wooden section. I-convert natin yan, no? Convert natin ito. Except yung bolt, of course. Hindi natin i-convert into wood section. Ito lang, mga steel reinforcement niya. Ayan. Convert natin into wood section. And likewise, the wood could be converted into an equivalent steel section. Okay? And vice versa. So, now the conversion factor is the quantity N. Okay? Or the modular ratio. It is the ratio of the modulus of elasticity of the steel divided by the modulus of elasticity of wood. Okay? Yan yung modular ratio. Okay? So this is an example of the transformed section. So ito yung section originally. May wood section tayo. At saka meron tayong reinforcement dito sa bottom. So, wood and steel section. Now, this is the equivalent wood section. Okay? So, ibig sabihin ay lalaki na ito kasi mas malakas yung steel kaysa wood. Ko-convert natin ito into wood section. I-multiply natin yung ito, B. Okay, width ng metal reinforcement, multiply natin with the modular ratio. Okay, so ito ang i-multiply natin, hindi yung thickness, na? So kasi dapat yung fiber na ito, outer fiber, ay parehas din yung position niya, okay, dito sa original. Hindi pwedeng, kapag ito ang minultiply mo, kapag yung thickness ang minultiply mo ng N, ay lalampas na dito yung wood, yung section. Okay? So, hindi na yung fiber ay hindi na pareha sa distance niya from the neutral axis. Dapat yung fibers ay parehas ang distance from the neutral axis kahit transform pa natin. Okay? And then, pwede rin i-transform into equivalent steel section. So, itong wood, i-convert natin into steel para steel na lang lahat. Okay? So, in short, ang gusto nating mangyari ay magiging, tawag nito, homogeneous yung ating beam. Homogeneous. Homogeneous. Okay? Ganun ba? Okay. So, the strains of the steel and the wood fibers at the interface or point A, this one, interface, the connection of the steel and the wood, are equal, supposed to be. So, from there, the strain of the steel should be equal to the strain of the wood. Okay? So, strain of the steel is equal to the stress in the steel divided by the modulus of elasticity. Okay? And likewise with the wood, kanyan din. So, if they are equal, equate natin itong dalawa. Ganyan siya. So, Fs is equal to E sub S divided by E sub W multiplied by the Fw or stress in the wood. So since E sub S divided by E sub W is N, then Fs is equal to N Fw. Now, flexural stress of the wood is equal to Mc over I. Therefore, flexural stress of the steel divided by the modular ratio is equal to Mc over I. Okay? So, the loads carried by the equivalent fibers should also be equal. So, Ps equals Pw. Okay? Ayan. Ito yung derivation. And so, F sub S over Fw is equal to Aw over As, or the cross-sectional area of the wood and the cross-sectional of the steel. Take note, this is the transformed section already. Okay? and so this one. Okay? Now, for the examples, we have example number one. So a beam is built by nailing together 25 mm thick planks to form 200 by 250 mm back section as shown. So this is the back section. This is the span. This is the load. The nails are spaced 1 to 5 mm apart and each can carry a shearing force of up to 1.3 kilonewtons. Okay, the beam is simply supported for a span of 3.6. Okay. So, the allowable shearing stress is 0.827. Determine the largest value of P that will not exceed the allowable shearing stress of the beam. Or the allowable shearing stress of the shearing force of the nails. Okay. So, what is the maximum fractional stress of the beam or the load for the load P computed? Okay. So, tingnan natin. Now, the moment of inertia of the section is just the sum of the moment of inertia of the two of the four areas. Okay? So, ito yung so isa. Okay? So, 150 by 25 ito. 150 by 25 ito. And this is 25 by 250. May dalawa. May dalawang patayong rectangle, may dalawang pahiga na rectangle, yun yung apat. Okay? So, ito, total is, multiply lang natin ng 2 kasi dalawa yung, tigda dalawa naman sila. Okay? So, and this is the result. So, moment of inertia can be also computed by considering the gross section of the area of the section minus the area of the hollow part. So, take note na meron tayong hollow portion. Box beam ang tawag kasi niyan, kaya merong hollow portion. Okay? So, isubtract lang natin. Itong formula nito ay galing din sa formula na yan. Okay? So, makikita niyo itong hollow section tsaka itong overall dimension, dalawang rectangle siya. Okay? So, isubtract lang natin. So, subtract, parehas naman ng result. Okay? So, this is easier. So, value of P based on the strength of nails. Okay? From the shear diagram, nakita natin that V is equal to 2/3 P ang maximum shear. So, since there are two bolts to be considered, ito, dalawang bolts na ito. Ayan. So, kasi pag nag-bend yan, mag-i-slide sana itong wooden section na ito. Pero hahawakan siya ng mga screw. Okay, so ano yung kaya yung value ng P para hindi masira yung mga bolts na yan? Or yung wood? Okay, so R, the strength of the screw, since 1,300 newton or 1.3 kilonewton ang given na capacity ng isang screw, pero meron tayong dalawa, kaya times 2. So, 2,600 newton. Okay? So, since it is symmetrical with respect to the horizontal axis, okay, kunin lang natin yung kalahati. Ito yung neutral axis. Okay? So, the highlighted 25 by 150 plank tends to slide horizontally. Okay? So, hence, Q is the moment of this area about the neutral axis. So, ito yung area. Kunin natin yung moment niya from the neutral axis. So, this area, 25 by 150 multiplied by the distance of its centroid. So, yung kalahati niya, ito yung centroid, 112.5. So, we have 421875 mm³. Yan yung static moment of area. So, and of course, the from the spacing, okay, formula of spacing of the nails or the screw ba yan? Nails, okay? So, whatever, basta given yung kanyang, hindi ko pala, nails ata, okay? So, Ito yun. So, 1, 2, 5 ang spacing. 2, 6 yung kanyang R. At saka yung moment of inertia ng section ay this one. Maximum shear and the static moment of area. Therefore, the P based on the maximum shear strength of the nails or the screw is just 11.86 kilonewtons. Okay? Pero hindi lang yung screw ang magfe-fail, kundi pati na rin yung wood. Okay? Kahit napakalakas ng screw, kung magfe-fail din yung ating wood, problem pa rin. Okay, so let's check value of P based on shear strength of wood. So the maximum shear occurs at the neutral axis of the section. Dito. Okay, dito yung maximum shear. Okay, so take note, sa neutral axis ang maximum shear. Okay, so ito, kukunin natin yung kanyang static moment of area. So, or we could, the static moment of area of the gross section. Okay, kaya 1 to 5, this is 1 to 5 times 200 times the distance of the centroid dito. Okay, so 1 to 5 divided by 2 kasi yan. Minus 100, ito yung 100 times 150 times 100 divided by 2. So, dito yung centroid. Okay? Kasi hollow part yan. So, we have 812,500. So, FV, the allowable. So, ayan. For wood, the allowable shearing strength is 0.827. Okay, equals VQ over IB. Ito yung, so makukuha ulit natin yung value ng P, which is 12.25. So mas malakas pala yung kahoy natin kasi kaya niya ng 12.25. Pero yung ating screw, kaya lang nila ay 11.86. Kaya yung mas maliit ang ating gagawing load para pasado yung dalawa. Okay? So, ito yung gagamitin nating value ng P. Okay? So, the maximum flexural stress also can be found by this formula. Okay? So, from the shear diagram, the maximum moment is this one. So, 9.488. Okay? So, ang value ng P na natin dito ay 11.86 kilonewton. So, kilonewton meter tayo. Ayan. So, ang flexural stress na maximum ay 7.39 MPa. Okay? So, yan yung sagot natin sa example. Now, example number 2. Meron tayong reinforced beam. Okay? 4 meters ang span. Reinforced at the bottom by steel plate 10 mm thick. So, meron din tayong 20 kilonewton meter na load. And then steel plate, ano yung kanyang width? Okay? So, we will assume a modular ratio of 15. So, allowable bending stresses in the wood and steel are 10 and 120 MPa respectively. Okay? So, the moment resisted by the beam is just WL squared over 8. Okay, which is 40 kilonewton meter. Moment capacity of the wood alone. Okay, tingnan natin. Baka naman kaya. Okay? Kaya hindi na kailangan ng reinforcement. So, moment capacity of the wood is 15.625, which is less than the maximum moment. Therefore, reinforcement is necessary. So, let's try. So, determine the width of steel plate if thickness is 10 mm. So, 10 mm ang given na thickness. So, i-transform natin. So, transform natin, multiply natin ng modular ratio yung width ng steel. But unknown yung width ng steel, so it's just 15B. So, and kukunin din natin yung moment of inertia. Kumbaga, ito yung rectangle na buo. Ayan, gross section. So, 15B times 250 plus 20. Ayan, 270 divided by 12. Isubtract natin itong dalawang hollow. Okay, dito sa magkabilaan. So, 15B minus 150 lang ito. So, 150 minus natin yung wood. Okay? So, ito yung kanyang moment of inertia in terms of B. So, width of steel based on the allowable flexural stress of steel. Okay? So, makukuha natin yung C or the yung pinakamalayong distance from the neutral axis. Okay? To the outermost fiber. So, 250 plus 10 plus 10 is 270 divided by 2. 135. Since symmetrical yung ating section, saka sa ano lang siya? Parehas yung distance from both compression fiber and the tension fiber. Sa formula natin na siya na-derive kanina, flexural stress of steel is over N is MC over I. So, makikita natin dito na B based on the flexural stress of steel, okay, is 94.57 mm. Also, the width of steel based on the allowed flexural stress of wood, so this is the flexural stress of wood, is 60.10. So, anong gagawin natin dito? Anong gagamitin nating width? Therefore, ang mas malaki para hindi mag-fail, ito yung kailangan reinforcement. So, it is 94.57. Kung load naman ang pinag-uusapan, dapat yung mas maliit na load. Okay? Dahil, mag-fail kung mag-fail yung isang material kung mas malaki yung load naman. Okay? So, yun yung mga. Another example shown below is partial floor framing plan of building. The load were indicated on the plan, including live loads here. So, B1 is a flitch beam composed of steel plate sandwiched between the two 100 by 300 mm wood planks. Steel plate will have the same depth as the planks, determine the required thickness of A36 steel. So, these are the properties of the wood and the A36 steel. Okay, so A36 is just the grade of the steel. Okay, I think 36K is ayan. Okay, so, yan. So, 250 MPa ang yield strength niya. So, the allowable flexural stress is just 0.6 of the yield strength. And modulus of elasticity is 200,000 MPa. Okay, so this is for the wood also. So, meron tayong floor framing plan. Iko-consider natin ang B1. So, ito yung B1. So, meron siyang ilan yung span niya? So, 7 meters ang total minus 2 meters. Ibig sabihin, we have 5 meters span. Okay? So, ito yung kukonsider natin. May 9 kPa on both sides. So, tingnan natin yung tributary area. No? Ito yung tributary area. Kalahati. Kalahati ang kanyang hawakan both sides. So, ang tributary width niya is 2.5. Okay? Times the and tributary load niya. So, loading. So, when tang span, tributary width, 2.5. So, W or the uniform load is 22.5 kilonewton per meter. Okay? So, moment. Design moment is 70.31 kilonewton meters. Napakaliki ng kanyang design moment. So, moment capacity of wood alone is 21.9 kilonewton meter. Okay? Ang wood lang i-consider natin dito. Kaya kailangan ng reinforcement na naman. So, we will transform the yung nakapalaman na steel dito into wood section. Multiply natin ng modular ratio. Okay, so since pare-parehas ng wood siya at parehas yung height, rectangular section na siya. Okay, so this is the moment of inertia based on or in terms of T. Ayan. So thickness in terms of maximum wood stress, okay, is 21.4. And thickness in terms of maximum steel stress, okay, so of course this is also from the formula. Ayan. So 21.57, okay, so halos magkaparehas lang sila, no? So therefore the safe thickness of steel shall be 21.57, or syempre walang commercial size na ganyan, 25 mm na siya, 1 inch thick yung palaman niya ganyan. Okay, so thank you for watching.